If you overcame COVID in 2021, make some noise. If you looked back, you looked up, and you're looking forward, make some bigger noise.
Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thinking over my life like I'm having a midlife crisis. Good decisions, bad decisions, hazardous living, revisiting my past successes and failures because my best friend is diagnosed with cancer and he's having regrets with his enemy and his organs that's posing a threat to his existence, and it got me wondering, did I do everything that I desire to do? Am I living life to the fullest, living my life like it's golden, or just sitting here waiting for the heavens to open, wasting time that is precious because this feeling of feeling restless has added unnecessary stresses? And as of right now, we are faced with our own mortality. The truth is, nobody lives forever. And we've known these facts since way back, since street cats been smoking black in mouths. The closer you get to 50, it's more than get rich or die trying. And I'm sick of being called into the principal's office for non-compliance. Got me analyzing the past, taking an honest self-assessment. Good decisions, bad decisions, SWOT analysis, strengths and weaknesses, opportunities and threats. Am I living up to my full potential? I got college credentials and a master's degree, but I still feel like a runaway slave refusing to work on the plantation of yesterday. Though my gifts haven't been fully utilized, though I've been brilliant in my children's eyes, I still wake up in the morning, mourning the shoulda, woulda, couldas. But I respect the process. But this nonsense isn't past tense, so I look to the hills.
Isaiah 55, 8 through 9. The Lord says, my thoughts are not like your thoughts. My ways are not like your ways. Just as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways and thoughts higher than your thoughts and ways. To paraphrase, say la. Let's look at two scriptures that should have been governing our days.
Romans chapter 8, verse 28. For all things work together for the good of those who love the Lord and are called according to his purpose.
For we were purchased by the blood of the Lamb, blood bought just like the land in which we stand in, for which he was battered, whipped, and bruised for our iniquities, in which he was not the actor, he was the stand-in. So in all thy ways acknowledge him and be content. Watch the content you feed yourself. Such as negative thoughts about last year, release them. Free yourself. For in Christ there's more liberty than bells on high school days. Daily we must strive to do the right thing. Spike Lee school days. We must give God praise for the simple things most folks take for granted. We're still here for another year, standing on the rock, going through metamorphosis. Granted. All our problems, he handled it all to him. Though it may have looked grim, he came through for us right on time, time after time, as we waited on him. Psalms 121, 1 through 2. So we look to the hills from which cometh our help. Our help cometh from the Lord.
I lift my eyes to the mountain because I know that my help comes from Yahweh. I'm learning to see things from heaven's vantage point, being reminded that we sit in heavenly places. It's a location of where his face is, so when we're faced with obstacles and stopping is not optional, when things often go haywire, we are mindful that all things are possible when we get reacquainted with the God we serve. It is needful that we recite his words, keep these scriptures on our lips, meditate on it, remember it, then we'll be successful and prosperous, because Yahweh, our God, will be with us wherever we go. Even if it rains or snows, our king's reign never plateaus. We see mountain high, even if our feelings are valley low. We look to the hills from where our help comes. We look to the eternal. We look up, look up to the eternal. Take notice of the heavens, because all things work together for the good of those who love the Lord. We look to the eternal, and our failures happen, but faith is not determined by them. Try him. Don't be afraid to run this race as many times as Joe Biden, because victory occurs when we look forward.
You made the heavens and the earth. You own the cattle on a thousand hills. You and you alone are the one true living God. There's no reason to fear now in the coming year. Your presence is a present. We will dwell here with the listening ear so that we hear your instructions clear as we reverence. Omnipotent, almighty, omnipresent God, we worship you. We look up to you for guidance and seek to stay in your perfect will. Let us pray for the future, for it is drawing near. Let us pray for the future, for it is drawing near. Draw not to God, resist the devil, standard protocol for the new year. We always know your blessing will flow. You have our best interests at heart. Cover us with your blood and protection like the hoodie on Luke Cage's head. Call hearts. Let us get back to the scripture. Revelation is clear and can come through subtext. Try the spirit, bow the spirit. The Holy Spirit will help us navigate through all subjects in the coming year. 2022 will be filled with numerous opportunities. We pray that God will both help us embrace and identify the right opportunities for us as a body, ministry, for our families, and individually. Please give us the wisdom it takes to not fall back into past hurt, pain, and misery.
Looking forward. Looking towards the day where every knee will bow, tongue confession. Looking forward to seeing the resurrected King in his perfection. Because it's guaranteed that our God won't keep us waiting like Dr. Dre in detox. Looking forward to where flies drop. Looking forward to where excuses drop like flies hitting the bug zapper on summer afternoons. Looking forward to hope building like anticipation soon. Soon sons and daughters of God will claim their communities like mission fields, invigorating the lost to proclaim the name of, to reconnect to the master. Can you envision universities and prisons reclaiming the name of their savior, whether it's jail bars or bars at churches? Cheers, because the kingdom is a better place where
everybody knows your name.
Where we cross cultures to bring the cross across cultures, declaring the promises that was made to Judah and doubting Thomas without seeing the piercings in his hands and feet, We're looking forward to being in the camp where we celebrate the enemy's defeat. We believe. Can you imagine that we got divine pedicures, because the scripture says how beautiful are the feet of those who bring the good news of peace. Ephesians chapter 5 verses 15 to 18. So be careful how you live. Do not live like those who are not wise. Live wisely. Use every chance you have for doing good.
Don't be foolish. Learn what the Lord wants you to do. Do not be drunk with wine, for it will ruin you. But be filled with the Spirit. Allow Him to lead you in all things you do
in 2022. God bless. Amen.